For the majority of their career, actors spend a lot of time auditioning and accepting just about every role that they come across, hoping to land that one role that changes it all. It's a long, hard road to the top, and usually when you get there, you find you have enough star power to finally start saying no to movie roles. Sometimes for personal reasons, sometimes professional, whatever the reason may be, we are going to count down 8 movie roles that movie stars shockingly turned down right here on Listed. Remember James Cameron's Avatar? The 3-day spectacular that raked in over $1 billion worldwide? Yeah, chances are that you've probably seen it yourself, but how different would that movie be if it starred Matt Damon? That's right, the Good Will Hunting star turned down the lead role in Avatar to film Green Zone. Haven't heard of it? Me neither. But I don't think Matt Damon has any regrets. In an interview when asked why he turned down the role, he said, quote, "I remember talking to my mother, and my mother said, you don't always have to go into the jungle and lose a bunch of weight. You're allowed to have fun. And I finally did the Farrelly Brothers movie, Stuck on You. And that was where I met my wife. 4 kids later, that was a pretty fateful decision." Next on our list is one of our favorite wizards, Hermione Granger. I mean, Emma Watson. That's who it is. She's probably so tired of wizard jokes by now. After all, she is wickedly talented and probably wants to be known for more than just wizarding around. Emma was offered the lead role in La La Land opposite Miles Teller, but she turned it down due to filming Beauty and the Beast. She said it was because of schedule conflicts, but I think it's also a smart publicity move. I mean, who wants to go from wizard to that girl in all the musicals? Smart move on Watson to just go straight to Disney and become a living princess. But we gotta admit, she would have killed it in La La Land. Miles Teller? I'm not so sure. Speaking of Beauty and the Beast, there is another beauty out there who actually had the guts to turn down this beast of a movie, and it's Beyoncé. The director of Beauty and the Beast, Bill Condon, revealed that he strongly considered Beyoncé after seeing her big role in the film Dreamgirls. But Beyoncé turned down the part, well, because it wasn't big enough. Come on, Bill Condon, you should have offered her the role of Belle so Beyoncé could be the queen bee of the ball. Come on. Let's keep it going with these movie musicals because they seem hard to cast. For example, when they were remaking the Kevin Bacon classic Footloose, they had a hard time finding a leading man after Zac Efron turned it down. That's right, Wildcat Zac Efron turned down the starring role in Footloose because the script just wasn't any good. Rumors were flying that he turned the role down to work on more and more dramatic roles coming from a world of Disney and High School Musicals, but it turns out it just wasn't any good. And he's kind of right, the movie doesn't really hold a flame to the Kevin Bacon original. Appearing for the second time on our list is our boy Matt Damon. Apparently, he loves saying no. When Christopher Nolan was trying to cast arguably the best Batman film ever, The Dark Knight, he was trying to find a young, handsome politician type who could play the role of Harvey Dent, aka Two-Face. A couple of phone calls later, and Matt Damon got offered the role in the film, but unfortunately could not accept due to scheduling. So Aaron Eckhart got the gig, to which Matt Damon replied, quote, "Look, Aaron is a great actor, so the movie didn't suffer for it. Every once in a while, you get an acting opportunity and you can't do it." It seems to be scheduling conflicts that are causing actors to turn down movie roles the most, but maybe that's just a polite excuse? A perfect example of this is the next person on our list, Emily Blunt. She turned down the role for Black Widow in Iron Man 2. And it's hard to imagine Black Widow without thinking of Scarlett Johansson, and I think we can all agree she rocked that role. But Emily Blunt would have put Scarlett's performance to the test. She reportedly turned down the role to, you guessed it, scheduling conflicts. But Deadline.com reported that it was actually due to not enough compensation. Simply put, Emily Blunt said, nah, I'm worth more than that, and she passed. It would be hard to turn down an action movie, especially an action movie where you play an iconic spy named James Bond. It's hard to think of James Bond without imagining the charmingly handsome Daniel Craig, but before Bond went blonde, the franchise had other actors in mind. In fact, Hugh Jackman revealed that he was asked to play 007 before they cast Daniel Craig, but declined because of his role as Wolverine in the X-Men films, which I really don't blame him. Being a super mutant is already pretty awesome. Last but certainly not least, another leading lady who turned down a huge role on a space film that went on to win an Oscar. Any guesses? Huh? Huh? If you guessed Gravity starring Sandra Bullock, then you are correct. Because according to Variety magazine, Bullock wasn't the first pick for the lead. It was actually Angelina Jolie. But unfortunately, due to contracts and paychecks, a deal couldn't be worked out between Angelina and the studio, which makes us wonder how much she was asking, because Sandra Bullock made about $70 million. Well, that does it for 8 movie roles that stars shockingly turned down for one reason or another. Thank you so much for joining me on Listed today. And if you want more of these, be sure to click right here to see 12 actors who hated their own movies. And be sure to subscribe to Clevver News for more fresh updates. I'm your host, Tom Plumlee, and I'll see you next time.